Hey guys, I spontaneously decided to make a fourth video to recreate the effect we actually had in Houdini. Yeah, was it 15? I don't know. So this is my YouTube video, the old one, and I'm trying to recreate something in here, and this we will do today. It's not 100%. I really like these longer streaks here. I couldn't get them quite here, but yeah, maybe that's the detail, or maybe I should just have the fluid fall further. Anyway, we will just record it. It looks similar enough. Because in the other three videos I did before, which are uploading here right now, we did not get the same look. So yeah, and excuse me, I will use this as a blueprint for the actual values. But here is my actually new Houdini, and we will use it. So we will first create a sphere, disable the wireframe, and set this sphere in here to polygon, and I think I set this to 6 frequency. Let me quickly check if this is 2. No, actually I set it to 2. I was trying around with a little bit more resolution, but I found this is a bit better. So and basically we just click on where is it, particle fluids, and then emit particle fluid, click the sphere, hit enter again, and then we should see some particle fluid. Let's see. Yeah, there it is. So, and what I was doing, I was hitting L here for a bit more order, click the flip solver, go to volume motion, and in here I was using 15. No, you can't see anything. 15, so make the domain a bit smaller, and then here minus 15, I think, or maybe minus 20. So this should give us a little bit of more performance, I hope, at least, because it's really, really slow. And the flip fluid, the particle separation, I set to let's say for testing, let's say to 0.25, sorry. So it goes a bit faster now. Okay, here there's nothing happening. I will disable the gravity for now so that we see if there is something happen or not. And then we I set this to hide other objects so that we only see the particles here. And in here I press Control 2. So I set a quick mark, and in here I set in the sphere I set Control 1 so I can switch now easily. And by the way, these nodes are created by Houdini. I delete the interior and I hide the particle fluid. I do not want this, but I unhide the auto-dop network, where everything is simulated. So in here we got this created by Houdini. It's the surface, and this we can delete, and we will create our velocity values now in here. And for this we already have to set the polygon. We can use a point warp, and I will quickly go in here, and we should have some normals. We can check this by connecting, let me make this a bit bigger, connecting the normals to the velocity as a first test. Control B makes it smaller again. Go up with U. And then we have our velocity attribute added, and then we will rasterize it, volume rasterize attribute. We talked about this in the other videos. If you need more details, watch the other three videos, it will help. The attribute is called V, and that's it so far. And then we can check everything by using a volume trail node. Connect the sphere. Here there are the points which we want to trail, so the sphere has points because we set it to polygon. And here we have to connect the volume, and now we see, let me press F, so we see the velocity vectors point into the direction of the normals. So this is good. If we would not have normals, we would not see these velocity trails. And one gotcha here, do not do what I do now. I create a null here and I make this the output for the velocity, because here in this node we have a velocity field, but here we do not. So this is only for preview, so you have to output the velocity attribute directly. Let me just quickly test something. There's another nice node, it's a volume slice, which gives a good overview about the values. And in here, let me see. There's also no field in here, so this should also not work. So don't do this, it's just for preview. And what we see here, that all our rectangle or area is filled. So in here we should select normalize to clamped coverage. So now it represents our sphere a bit better, and we still see that almost all everything is filled with our values, even though we only create these velocity attributes for the points on the sphere. So to get the result we want, we can scale the particles a bit. And let me just quickly check what I used in here. A particle scale of 0.03, like so. Okay, yeah. And now this creates a little bit more interesting shape, because the fluid particles will get like the fluid particles generated in between here and here, they will get a little bit less speed than those are created here. So it gives just a bit better motion. We can later play a bit around with these values. And one thing I want also to mention, if you look at your volume now here, it looks like, hey, it only creates something for this right side of the sphere, but don't be mistaken, everything is okay, but these values here point to a negative direction, because the normals point into this direction, which is negative. You can see this here, there's this little axis, and negative values are not displayed as at least that's my explanation. Don't worry, everything is okay. And in here, let's test this. We go into the simulation. Here we create a volume source, and like so, we connect this to the third input, and we select our sphere out velocity. That's okay. We add another value here, set this to vector V, and careful, it's val and not V, the target field. You can see this here. Target field is val and not V. So that's a gotcha I took a lot of time to discover. And we add the volume, and we scale it about 3. Let me quickly check if this is true. 3, yes. Okay, so everything is good. And let's see if this gave us something. Yes. Okay, we have now some velocity values. So that's good. Okay. And now we can activate the gravity again, and this should give us already some values. So, okay. So now we want something else. We want to wiggle around the normals a little bit. So we are not just using the normal in here, we also create a random vector, which we add to the normal. So I create another node here, an add node. Oop. No, I disabled it. So we connect this. So I hope you can see this a little bit better now. The normal will be added to a random vector, and for the random vector, we add the frame, the current frame, to the point number, so that every frame, every point gets a different random value. And in here I set this to 1D to 3D vector, and then we do a fit node, because these vectors, as far as I know, generate random values between 0 and 1, and we want values between minus 1 and 1. So fit, where is it? Fit range, it's actually. And here we can make minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. We add this together, and this should be fine. So now we should see something, some different behavior. Let's go to the simulation, and now, it looks like this. Let's check if the wiggling actually works. We can see this here. Okay, everything is good, and the volume trails are also looking different now. Okay, so that's fine. And now we can tweak a little bit our values. Let me just, because everything you just saw is basically what we need to make it working. And now we will take the values of my other experiment here and make it hopefully look like this. So let's check. We have particle separation of 0.05 here. In my case, it was 0.25. So, okay, 0.15, I'm sorry. So then we have multiplicator of 3. Vector should be fine. This we did not change. Volume motion, everything is good. Let me check the domain. Yes. Ah, I made it a little bit shorter actually. So we have, I don't know if this changes a lot, but we will just be careful and take over all the values I used in the other example to get as close as possible. Because it does not look exactly like what I have here. So let's check. So this is okay. The particle scale should be fine. And the volume source. One thing I changed actually, let's see if this is the reason why it looks a bit different. I mean, it's quite okay, but it could be better. Is I set this to source flip. Actually, this is just prefabs, should not change anything. But just in case, I will set this here V to val and then a scaling of 3 again. And now I don't see too much. It looks very different. Oh yeah, I forgot. No, I did not. Here, this is still the sphere val output. Field to match density is okay. Operation. Here, this is minimum. It should be add, of course. So, okay, now this gives us a bit more motion. Actually, now it looks different. That's actually interesting. I wouldn't have expected that the source flip and source smoke is so different, but as you see, it is. Okay, we learned something new here. I have to read up this, because in here, I will just hover, it says configure the microsolver according to the selected preset. Ah, okay, the microsolver. Ah, okay, interesting. So, I think the microsolver is something in here, in the flip solver, in here somewhere. It's super complicated. And yeah, maybe now the behavior is a bit different. So that's good to know, by the way. I find that these simulations are kind of slow, and in here I already checked in my other file in the solver to use OpenCL, but it did not speed up the thing. And if you read the pop-up, it says that it mostly benefits from high-resolution fluid sims with viscosity, which we don't have. So. Maybe it's not even faster in our case. Okay, so we learned something. We should use the flip. And yeah, basically that's it. Let me double check what we can do. We can play a little bit around how the whole thing looks if I, for example, increase the resolution here so that our volume, let's see here, this was it before. So we had some gaps in between our particles which define the velocity values. Let's up the resolution of our sphere a little bit so that we get a more dense field. As you can see here, I can do it again. So, more dense field. And let's look how the simulation looks now, because I think I didn't like it that much. Let's see. Yeah, as you see, you don't get these nice thin streaks, because now more particles are catched and receive the same velocity, but it depends whatever you want, I guess. Also, of course, a big difference is how many fluid particles you use. It looks also interesting. Not that bad. Depends on the taste, of course. I explained this in another video, but you can go into your fluid object, and here there is, no, wait, here in the flip source, there is a shell thickness here. And if we show all the objects, go to frame one, then we see all these particles, the fluid particles created here. And if you reduce the shell thickness, then you get less of them. Yeah, because the shell in which they are created is a little bit thinner. And this is, can also be a method to give it a different look. Let's see how it looks now. Yeah, and now it gets more clustered as well, because there are big gaps in between the generated fluid particles. Yeah, can also be interesting. So yeah, we got some kind of a jellyfish here. Super cool. Okay, I hope this helped. This was a little update for the newer versions of Houdini, because the old video I did was not actually valid anymore, because they changed the so-called volume sourcing. So yeah. Okay, have fun. I hope you liked the video, and if so, you can comment. If not, you can comment too. And if you have a question, you can write it into the comments as well. Bye-bye.